On August 4th, China allowed its currency to weaken to its lowest level in 11 years. This move has significant implications for the global economy, interest rates around the world, and whether the trade war has now become a currency war. But for U.S. agriculture, concerned about exports to China, it's the relative movement of currencies among our competitors and the Chinese yuan that really matter. In other words, how has the euro, the Brazilian real, the Argentine peso, and the Australian dollar moved against the Chinese yuan since the trade dispute heated up last summer? And how does that compare with the movement of the U.S. dollar, Chinese yuan exchange rate? That will tell us whether U.S. products have become more or less competitive on pricing as it relates to currency. What we find is that the U.S. dollar has strengthened against the yuan since August 2018, while many of our competitors' currencies have weakened or stayed the same versus the yuan. The dollar has strengthened for a number of reasons, most of which have nothing to do with agriculture. But we know from a 2016 USDA study that export demand for U.S. bulk agricultural products is heavily influenced by the strength of the dollar. The study indicates that for every 1% increase in the U.S. dollar, the real value of U.S. ag exports declines by 3%. So over the past year, the dollar's rise has eroded value from U.S. ag exports by roughly 10%. At the same time, the currencies of our competitors have moved the other direction and made their ag exports more affordable to Chinese buyers. All of this is purely impacted by currency movements, and this compounds the issues related to tariffs imposed between the U.S. and China. And as China's economy continues to weaken and U.S. assets remain a safe haven during uncertain times, the U.S. dollar is unlikely to move substantially lower in the coming months.